أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ياسين والقرآن الحكيم. إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم. تنزيل العزيز الرحيم. لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون. لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون. إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون. وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون. وسواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. إنما تنذر من اتبع الذكر وخشي الرحمن بالغيب فبشره بمغفرة وأجر كريم. إنا نحن نحيي الموتى ونكتب ما قدموا وآثارهم وكل شيء أحصيناه في إمام مبين. واضرب لهم مثلا أصحاب القرية إذ جاءها المرسلون. إذ أرسلنا إليهم اثنين فكذبوهما فعززنا بثالث فقالوا إنا إليكم مرسلون. قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء إن أنتم إلا تكذبون. قالوا ربنا يعلم إنا إليكم لمرسلون وما علينا إلا البلاغ المبين. قالوا إنا تطيرنا بكم لئن لم تنتهوا لنرجمنكم وليمسنكم منا عذاب أليم. قالوا طائركم معكم أئن ذكرتم بل أنتم قوم مسرفون. وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى قال يا قوم اتبعوا المرسلين. اتبعوا من لا يسألكم أجرا وهم مهتدون. وما لي لا أعبد الذي فطرني وإليه ترجعون. أأتخذ من دونه آلهة إن يردني الرحمن بضر لا تغن عني شفاعتهم شيئا ولا ينقذون. إني إذا لفي ضلال مبين. إني آمنت بربكم فاسمعون. قيل ادخل الجنة قال يا ليت قومي يعلمون. بما غفر لي ربي وجعلني من المكرمين. وما أنزلنا على قومه من بعده من جند من السماء وما كنا منزلين إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم خامدون يا حسرة على العباد ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون ألم يروا كم أهلكنا قبلهم من القرون أنهم إليهم لا يرجعون وإن كل لما جميع لدينا محضرون وآية لهم الأرض الميتة أحييناها وأخرجنا منها حبا فمنه يأكلون وجعلنا فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب وفجرنا فيها من العيون ليأكلوا من ثمره وما عملته أيديهم أفلا يشكرون سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض ومن أنفسهم ومما لا يعلمون وآية لهم الليل نسلخ منه النهار فإذا هم مظلمون والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم لا الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر ولا الليل سابق النهار وكل في فلك يسبحون وآية لهم أنا حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون وخلقنا لهم من مثله ما يركبون وإن نشأ نغرقهم فلا صريخ لهم ولا هم ينقذون إلا رحمة منا ومتاعا إلى حين وإذا قيل لهم اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم لعلكم ترحمون وما تأتيهم من آية من آيات ربهم إلا كانوا عنها معرضين وإذا قيل لهم أنفقوا مما رزقكم الله قال الذين كفروا للذين آمنوا أنطعم من لو يشاء الله أطعمه إن أنتم إلا في ضلال مبين ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين ما ينذرون إلا صيحة واحدة تأخذهم وهم يخصمون فلا يستطيعون توصية ولا إلى أهلهم يرجعون ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون هم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام قولا من رب رحيم. وامتازوا اليوم أيها المجرمون. ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم ألا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين. وأن اعبدوني هذا صراط مستقيم. ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا أفلم تكونوا تعقلون. هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون. اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون. اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون. ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون. ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون. ومن نعمره ننكسه في الخلق أفلا يعقلون. وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين. لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين. أولم يروا أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون. وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون. ولهم فيها منافع ومشارب أفلا يشكرون. واتخذوا من دون الله آلهة لعلهم ينصرون. لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون. فلا يحزنك قولهم إنا نعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون. أولم يرى الإنسان أنا خلقناه من نطفة فإذا هو خصيم مبين. وضرب لنا مثلا ونسي خلقه قال من يحيي العظام وهي رميم. قل يحييها الذي أنشأها أول مرة وهو بكل خلق عليم. الذي جعل لكم من الشجر الأخضر نارا فإذا أنتم منه توقدون. أوليس الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم؟ بلى وهو الخلاق العليم. إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون. فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون. صدق الله العظيم.
اللهم آمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. اللهم إنا نستحفظك ونستودعك أدياننا وأبداننا وأنفسنا وأهلنا وأولادنا وأموالنا وكل شيء أعطيتنا. اللهم اجعلنا وإياهم في كنفك وأمانك وعياذك من كل شيطان مريد وجبار عنيد وذي بغي وذي حسد ومن شر كل ذي شر إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم جملنا بالعافية والسلامة وحققنا بالتقوى والاستقامة وأعذنا من موجبات الندامة إنك سميع الدعاء. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وأولادنا ومشايخنا وأصحابنا وإخواننا في الدين ولمن أحبنا فيك ولمن أحسن إلينا والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصل اللهم على عبدك ورسولك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وارزقنا كمال المتابعة له ظاهرا وباطنا في عافية وسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. يا الله يا الله يا الله. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله.
اللهم آمين آمين آمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله هو خيرا وأعظم أجرا واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم. أستغفر الله 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 العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله، 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 سيدنا محمد رسول الله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. 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 فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا علي يا عظيم، يا حليم يا عليم، أنت ربي وعلمك حسبي، فنعم الرب ربي ونعم الحسب حسبي، تنصر من تشاء وأنت العزيز الرحيم. نسألك العصمة في الحركات والسكنات والكلمات والإرادات والخطرات، من الشكوك والظنون والأوهام الساترة للقلوب عن مطالعة الغيوب. فقد ابتلي المؤمنون وزلزلوا زلزالا شديدا، وإذ يقول المنافقون والذين في قلوبهم مرض ما وعدنا الله ورسوله إلا غرورا. فثبتنا وانصرنا وسخر لنا هذا البحر كما سخرت البحر لموسى، وسخرت النار لإبراهيم، وسخرت الجبال والحديد لداود، وسخرت الريح والشياطين والجن لسليمان. وسخر لنا كل بحر هو لك في الأرض والسماء والملك والملكوت، وبحر الدنيا وبحر الآخرة. وسخر لنا كل شيء، يا من بيده ملكوت كل شيء. كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد. انصرنا فإنك خير الناصرين، وافتح لنا فإنك خير الفاتحين، واغفر لنا فإنك خير الغافرين، وارحمنا فإنك خير الراحمين، وارزقنا فإنك خير الرازقين، واهدنا ونجنا من القوم الظالمين، وهب لنا ريحا طيبة كما هي في علمك، وانشرها علينا من خزائن رحمتك، واحملنا بها حمل الكرامة مع السلامة والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم يسر لنا أمورنا مع الراحة لقلوبنا وأبداننا والسلامة والعافية في دنيانا وديننا وكن لنا صاحبا في سفرنا وخليفة في أهلنا واطمس على وجوه أعدائنا وامسخهم على مكانتهم فلا يستطيعون المضي ولا المجيء إلينا ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ياسين والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم تنزيل العزيز الرحيم لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وقد خاب من حمل ظلما طاسين حاميم عين سين قاف مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان حاميم 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 هم الأمر وجاء النصر فعلينا لا ينصرون حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير بسم الله بابنا تبارك حيطاننا ياسين سقفنا كاف ها يا عين صاد كفايتنا حاميم عين سين قاف حمايتنا فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم ستر العرش مسبول علينا وعين الله ناظرة إلينا بحول الله لا يقدر علينا والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم بسم الله والحمد لله رب العالمين. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله لطيف بعباده يرزق من يشاء وهو القوي العزيز يا لطيف 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 لطيف يا 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 لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير اللهم يا من لطفت في خلق السماوات والأرض ولطفت بالأجنة في بطون أمهاتها ألطف بنا لطفا يليق بكرمك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا الله اللهم يا من جعلت الصلاة على النبي من القربات نتقرب إليك بكل صلاة سليت عليه من أول النشأة إلى ما لا نهاية من الكمالات بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك
اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك.
إن شاء الله we'll continue with ذكر الجامعة. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وَسِعَهُ عِلْمُ اللَّهِ. Inshallah, we'll make dua now. اللهم آمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our Shaykh, teacher, murshid, and master, Sayyidina Shaykh Faisal Hamid Abdul Razak. O Allah, may you increase him in knowledge and wisdom. O Allah, may you protect him from evil, and we pray that he will lead his murids on the straight path towards you. O Allah, we pray for the Shaykh and his family. We pray that you strengthen them in Iman, keep them in good health, and grant them long life in Islam. O Allah, we pray that you protect them from all evil, ease their trials, and grant them the sweetness of paradise. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Allah, forgive us for our sins and guide us on the straight path leading to paradise. O Allah, you know the needs of all of us present here. O Allah, answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our parents that you grant them your grace and mercy as they raised us in childhood. O Allah, grant our parents long life and good health in Islam. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive our parents and grant them paradise. O Allah, for our parents who have passed away and returned to you, O Allah, we beg you to forgive them. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the murids of Shaykh Faisal throughout the world. O Allah, we pray that you ease our trials and grant us the strength to face our trials. O Allah, make it easy for us to gain true knowledge and to practice it, to be good murids and to get ever closer to you. O Allah, you know the needs of all of the murids. O Allah, we beg you to answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the Muslims around the world. O Allah, we pray that you strengthen us in Iman. O Allah, we pray for unity and to make us stronger as a nation. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please comfort and relieve all Muslims who are suffering and have suffered losses. O Allah, you are the all-powerful and the almighty. O Allah, we beg you to give us victory against the unbelievers. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for the International Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa. May you make it easy for us to establish many masjids for your sake. May you bless the Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa to be a beacon of light for Islam throughout the world. And may you help us to finish building the new masjid soon and make it easy for us to do so. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadan wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al-mursani walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله
اللهم آمين أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد صاحب التاج والمعراج والبراك والعلم دافع البلاء والوباء والقحط والمرض والألم اسمه مكتوب مرفوع مشفوع منكوش في اللوح والقلم
سيد العرب والعجم جسمه مقدس معتر مطهر منور في البيت والحرم شمس الدحى بدر الدجى صدر العلا نور الهدى كهف الورى مصباح الظلم جميل الشيم شفيع الأمم صاحب الجود والكرم والله عاصمه وجبريل خادمه والبراق مركبه والمعراج سفره وسدرة المنتهى مقامه وقاب قوسين مطلوبه والمطلوب مقصوده والمقصود موجوده سيد المرسلين خاتم النبيين شفيع المذنبين أنيس الغريبين رحمة للعالمين راحة العاشقين مراد المشتاقين شمس العارفين سراج السالكين مصباح المقربين محب الفقراء والغرباء والمساكين سيد الثقلين نبي الحرمين إمام القبلتين وسيلتنا في الدارين وسيلتنا في الدارين صاحب قاب قوسين محبوب رب المشرقين والمغربين جد الحسن والحسين جد الحسن والحسين مولانا ومولى الثقلين أبي القاسم محمد بن عبد الله نور من نور الله نور من نور الله يا أيها المشتاقون بنور جماله صلوا عليه وآله وأصحابه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين 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 لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله
محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا اللهم أعزنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأصلح لنا شأننا كله لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين آمين آمين أما بعد My dear brothers and sisters, my dear murids, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. And welcome to our special daily broadcast coming to you from the Islamic Forum of Canada here from your Zawiya here in Toronto, starting at 7 p.m. every day. We welcome you to our program today, and we hope you can join us every day, 7 p.m. Toronto time. We kindly request you to tell others, your family members, your relatives, your friends, other Muslims you know. Tell them about this program, encourage them to watch the program, share the YouTube link with them, and encourage them as well to sign into the chat with their name and city where they're from. Do remember to subscribe to the channel by clicking on the subscribe button. And next to the subscribe button, there's a bell icon. Click on the bell and select all for notifications. We want to thank all our donors, those who've donated to the Islamic Forum today, yesterday, and before. We thank them for their donation. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless them, bless their family, bless their loved ones, increase them in wealth, in his rizq, and accept all their dua because of their donation to the Islamic Forum. And we also want to make a special appeal to each and every one of you to make a generous donation to the Islamic Forum today. This program is concerned about your safety and your security, your well-being, your afia. Firstly, and then secondly, your spirituality, your connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and your connection to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so what we do in this program is geared towards achieving those two main objectives, your safety and your spirituality. To this end, we have special videos that have been prepared by the staff here at the Islamic Forum, and there are two series we've prepared so far. The editor's pick video, which is a weekly video that we produce for you, the staff here at the Islamic Forum produce for your benefit. and your viewing pleasure. And also the series of videos. This is a special series of videos prepared for you by the staff of the Islamic Forum on the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And every day we send out one email with this information. Information about our daily broadcast, the links for the different broadcasts every day, and then the links for the special video series, a new episode every day. So we request you to study the email carefully, the daily email that you receive. If you're not receiving the daily email from the Islamic Forum, please send us your email address and your telephone contact details so that we can make sure that you are added to the list and you receive this information, inshallah. There are several projects or action items we have to engage you in a productive way so that you can continue to benefit from the program and optimize the way you find this program useful and beneficial and continue your spiritual progress in your journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have the Quran project, which is for you to recite one page of the Quran, at least one page of the Quran every day. The Salawat project, to recite Salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we have a special book for this Salawat project. It's called Blessings of Salawat upon the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this book is now available on Amazon.com for you to obtain your copy. You go to the Amazon.com, and the link is in the chat. That you can click on that link and go to Amazon.com website and order your book, Blessings of Salawat, that talks much about the significance and benefits and blessings of Salawat, and specifically about the Salawat project. We also have the Dawah project, and this is for you to invite others to this program and thereby increase your blessings. The Infaq project, for you to donate whenever you're able to the Islam Forum and encourage others to do likewise. And then number six, the Home Zawiya project, for you to establish your Home Zawiya in your home and to use it in the ways that we have recommended, that you would gain much blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then your home would receive barakah and blessing, and the inhabitants of the home, your family members and loved ones, will receive special blessings because of the Home Zawiya that you establish in your home. And number six, the Gratitude project, and number seven, this is Dhikr project, for you to recite the Wird al-Am Dhikr twice a day, in the morning and in the evening. And when you're doing that, you let us know and I will instruct you as to the next steps in the next levels of dhikr that you can do. Today I want to focus on the Infaq project, this important ibadah, among the most virtuous of ibadah, of spending in way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of giving your sadaqah, your charity, your donation for the sake and pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Previously, I mentioned three important benefits. We talk about sadaqah or infaq being the proof of correctness of iman. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him, mentions in the hadith, was sadaqatu burhan, and sadaqah, your sadaqah you give, is a proof, meaning a proof of your faith, of the correctness of your faith. So it's a litmus test almost of the strength of your faith that you spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because many people find it difficult to spend for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though they are not losing their wealth when they spend for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their wealth would increase by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's a way of them transferring their wealth from this dunya into the akhirah, depositing their wealth in the bank account of the akhirah, so that they will benefit perpetually, continuously in the akhirah for spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet said, was sadaqatu burhan. Sadaqah is a proof of the correctness of your faith. And the second point we mentioned is, it is a cure for your illness. The Prophet alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, dawu mardakum bis sadaqah. And cure your patients with sadaqah. If someone in your family is ill, then you grant them cure, shifa, by giving sadaqah on their behalf. If you're ill, you give sadaqah to gain shifa from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the Prophet said, dawu mardakum bis sadaqah. Yes, obtain a cure for your illness by giving sadaqah, spending in a way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And thirdly, among the benefits of sadaqah, to be in the shade of Allah's protection. The Prophet alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in hadith, kullu mri'im fi dhilli sadaqatihi hatta yufsalu bayna nas. Every person will be in the shade of his or her sadaqah until judgment is passed on the yawmul qiyamah. So while people are busy facing judgment and enduring and facing the grievous conditions, difficult, harsh conditions of the day of judgment, for example, the hadith mentioned that the sun is so close to them that it's so hot on the day of judgment. People are perspiring on the day of judgment, and the perspiration is falling down and causing a ground swelling, a flood of perspiration rising up until it reaches their chins, almost drowning in their perspiration on the day of judgment. So difficult it is. People facing that, when others who give sadaqah in this world will be in the shade of protection of their sadaqah. Their sadaqah will come as a shade for them, to shade them from the heat and take them out of that punishment on the day of judgment. Another hadith says that those special believers will be on a mountain of musk. Musk is the sweetest smelling perfume. When people facing judgment in those difficult conditions, they would be elevated to be on a mountain of musk, to receive the blessings and ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fourth point I want to mention today is that sadaqah, spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, infaq fi sabilillah, is a protection from the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam says, sadaqah tusir tutfi ghadab ar-rabb. That the sadaqah, especially the secret sadaqah you give, that only you know about it and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it wipes out or it gets rid of the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with someone, then their life is a life of chaos and confusion, punishment and problems, disasters and difficulties in this way. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with someone. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with someone, then their life are blessed with sakina, with felicity and tranquility, happiness and so on, peace of mind, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy with them. And so one of the ways of getting rid of the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to give regular charity, to give regular sadaqah, to engage in infaq, in spending in a way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's a practice of one of the blessed companions, one of the noble companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sayyidina Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiyallahu anhu. This noble companion, he had this practice that the other Sahabas noticed, and they asked him about it, about this practice. And that is, in Masjid al-Nabawi in Medina, every day after each salah, each of the five daily salah, he would give some sadaqah. No matter how small it is, he would give some sadaqah after each salah. And then the Sahabas asked him, Ya Abu Dharr, why do you give sadaqah after each salah? And he responded to them. He said, do you not read the book of Allah, the Quran? Wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran commands us to pray, he also commands us to give sadaqah. Without exception, throughout the Quran. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةَ. Either immediately after that command, in the same ayah or in the next ayah, it's connected. The command to perform prayer and the command to give sadaqah, to spend in a way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he understood this, and he would give sadaqah after each and every salah to teach us that important lesson. And yet again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the case of people who, on the day of judgment, when they're faced with judgment, they would beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send them back in the dunya. رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ. They beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send them back into the dunya, give them another chance. And one of the things that's mentioned in the Quran that they beg to go back into the dunya to do is to give sadaqah, to spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they see, on that day of judgment, when they see the great benefits of sadaqah, of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So sometimes in this world they are hijabs, they are obstacles in front of us, preventing us, or shields in front of us, preventing us from seeing the true reality. So rather than spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people say, oh, I need to keep this money, I'll get more rich, and I'll wait until I'm very wealthy, a millionaire, multimillionaire, then I'll give for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that may never happen. That may never happen. So the correct approach, the correct response is to spend regularly in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no matter how small it is. No matter how small it is. So when people would see the great benefits in the akhirah of giving sadaqah, they beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, send me back into the dunya so that I can engage in sadaqah, spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what they would say. So now, the fifth point I want to mention after protection from the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to gain the mahabba, or the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions on the tongue of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, so the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, ahabbul a'mali ilallahi ta'ala sururun tadkhuluhu ala muslimin aw takshifu anhu kurba aw tuqda anhu daynan, and so on in hadith, that among the most beloved good deeds to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is for you to put a smile on the face of a Muslim, or put happiness, the feeling of happiness, in the heart of a Muslim, or remove from him or her a difficulty, a problem they are facing, or take care of their debt, and so on. This way of spending for others, taking care of others, being mindful of others, that you would do. Do you gain the mahabba of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because this is a deed which is loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so we should strive to gain this mahabba, this love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us by doing these wonderful deeds. Among the great benefits of sadaqah is increase in sustenance, increase in your rizq, increase in barakah in your life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, yamhaqullahu riba wa yurbi sadaqat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants gain and profit and increase because of sadaqat, because of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam mentioned the hadith, ma naqasa malu abdin min sadaqah, that the wealth of the servant of Allah will never decrease because of him or her spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning it will certainly increase. Your wealth will increase when you spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes. Your wealth will increase. It never decreases because of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, people may say that, oh, I have $1,000. If I spend $500 in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means I lose $500, I only have $500 remaining. No. What this hadith is teaching us is that your wealth increases. Many ways, different ways in which it happens. Among the ways is the increase of barakah. The increase of barakah, blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your wealth. So that $500 that remain with you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts barakah in that, blessings in that. So that you're spending it, you're buying things and so on, and it doesn't seem to be finishing. You're gaining so much from it. You're benefiting so much from that $500 that remain with you, because there's barakah in it. And I'm sure you may have experienced this in your life. Sometimes you have some money and you're buying things, you're getting things, and it doesn't seem to be going away. It's still with you. In that way, when you don't have barakah in your wealth, it goes away, and it's as if you have nothing to show for it. It just goes away. It's finished. You spend it, and then you look back and you don't see anything from that money. It just goes away because there's no barakah in that wealth. Also, when there's barakah in that wealth, it brings other blessings in your life, other ni'mah that comes to you, happiness and health and afiyah and well-being and the well-being of your family, your loved ones, your spouse, your parents, your children, your siblings, and so on, your loved ones, brings happiness to them because of the barakah in your wealth and the things that you gain from that wealth, it's of benefit to many people, benefit to many people. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this barakah that comes in your wealth. So the Prophet says, مَا نَقَسَ مَالُ عَبْدٍ مِنْ صَدَقَةٍ. And in one riwayah of the hadith, the Prophet took an oath by Allah. He says, by Allah. He took an oath by Allah that this will happen. That your wealth will never decrease because of spending it in a way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, so important it is. And the Prophet is a sadiq al-masduq. He is the truthful one. If he says this, it's the truth. This is the guarantee we have. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only speaks the truth in the Quran. If he reveals this in the Quran, this is the truth. Your wealth will never decrease because of spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It blesses. Spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses your wealth. And this is why one of the pillars of Islam, one of the five pillars of Islam, is to spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, zakat, to give 2.5% of what you have every year. Because of the great blessings for you. Just as how when you perform your salah, a pillar of Islam, you gain blessings. You fast in Ramadan, you gain blessings. You perform hajj, you gain blessings. In this way, similarly, you give zakat, you gain blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not punishment, not reducing your wealth, it increases. And it's so important that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this one of the five pillars of Islam. As the Prophet said in hadith, Buniya al-Islamu ala khamsin, there are five pillars of Islam, and he mentioned wa ita'i zakat, and to give zakat, to give sadaqah in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a blessing and an honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has blessed us and granted us this opportunity to spend in his way. A blessing and an honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the great, wonderful rewards that he has promised us in the dunya and in the akhirah for spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The companions are the greatest examples of this. The Prophet alayhi salallahu alayhi wa sallam used to appeal to the sahabas, the companions, the Muslims, then to spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to engage in infaq, to engage in sadaqah, to give of their wealth, to support the Muslim causes, expeditions and other needs, to give to the Baitul Mal, to take care of the Muslim community, and they would give. And the great example of Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Sayyidina Umar. Sayyidina Umar always would try to compete with Sayyidina Abu Bakr to give more for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how they were. The great examples that we have to follow. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us to be from among the men and women of sadaqah, the men and women of infaq, those who can spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in rizq, increase us in our wealth, increase us in his blessings upon us and upon our families and upon our children and upon their children and our future generation because we spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to do so, put that feeling in our heart so we can spend in his way. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to do great deeds for his deen so we can promote this deen and we can strengthen this deen all through spending in a way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بيبي آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بيبي آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے پورو غلما بھی خوشیاں جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و غلمان بھی خوشیاں منانے لگے ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی مل گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی
love.
إله إلا الله لا 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 إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وأنت يا حي يا قيوم إذا شئت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا اللهم أعزنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأصلح لنا شأننا كله لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين آمين آمين أما بعد. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I greet you with the greetings of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. We start today a special series based on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the Quran in Surah Yunus, ayah number 62. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون لهم البشرى في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة لا تبديل لكلمات الله ذلك هو الفوز العظيم. Behold, verily, the friends of Allah, the awliya of Allah, they shall have no fear, nor shall they grieve. Ala inna awliya Allahi la khawfun alayhim wa la hum yahzanun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a special status of his awliya. The awliya are the saints of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the special friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the next ayah, number 63, Surah Yunus, chapter 10. Alladhina amanu wa kanu yattaqun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes them now. They are the people who truly believe in Allah and always remain God-fearing, committed to piety. And then in ayah number 64, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals, There is for them glad tidings of honor and recognition in the life of this world, and also of forgiveness and recognition in the hereafter. No change can there be in the words of Allah. This is indeed the supreme success. لَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. They receive the glad tidings, the good news of honor and recognition in the life of this dunya, this world. And also, they receive the good news of forgiveness and recognition in the hereafter. لَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. لَا تَبْدِيلَ لِكَلِمَاتِ اللَّهِ. You will find no change in the words of Allah, in the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. And this indeed is a supreme success, the ultimate success, the really true success with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a special category of believers, the awliya. The awliya from among the believers, you have the special group of believers, the awliya, that are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses them to manage His creation. Through them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala distributes His bounties to the creation, to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He is the distributor, Al-Qasim, and through Him now, His awliya, from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the awliya of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the great believers over these past 14 centuries. Now, among the great awliya is Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani radiyallahu anhu. And so today we want to say something about his life, about the lessons we can learn from his life, and to understand the greatness of this individual, Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani radiyallahu anhu, a great spiritual giant of Islam, a spiritual personality of Islam, His Eminence Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani radiyallahu anhu. He was born in a region called Jilan, and that's his name is called Jilani nisbatan ilal Jilan, because that's where he came from. And Jilan is in the northwestern province of Iran, south of the Caspian Sea, north of Elburz chain. It is bounded in the east by Tabristan and Mandaran, and its northern limit is marked with the junction of the Khor and Araxes, and its political boundary with Russia is marked by the Astara stream. It is one of the most beautiful areas in Iran. So, that's where he was born, in the city of Jilan, or the region of Jilan, and so he became known as Jilani. And this is a common feature in naming of especially great outstanding people. The place where they came from is added to their name. You know, for example, the Sahih Bukhari, the greatest, most authentic collection of hadith, written by Imam Bukhari. His name is not Bukhari. That's the region or the city where he came from the Central Asian Republics, the city of Bukhara. So it's called Bukhari. It's Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Ismail, his name, but people know him by this title, referring to the place of his birth, where he came from. So that's a common feature in naming, especially of outstanding and great people, great scholars. So Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani from Jilan, but he was actually of Arab descent, being the 10th descendant of Sayyidina Imam Hassan ibn Ali, the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the son of Sayyidina Imam Ali and Sayyidina Fatima al-Zahra, Imam Hassan. He descended from both Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein. From his father's side, Imam Hassan. From his mother's side, Imam Hussein. So he is Hassani and Husseini, Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani.
He was born in the year 470 AH after the Hijra. And he died at the age of 90 in the year 561 after the Hijra, corresponding to 1166 of the Christian era. As you said, he was an Arab by descent, but belonged to this place of Gilan by migration of his ancestors. They migrated to that place, they settled there, he was born there. From his father's side, he descended from Imam Hassan, the tenth generation from Imam Hassan, Rajallahu Anhu, wa alayhi salam. So he is from Ahlul Bayt. He is from the family of the Prophet, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. And a distinguished lineage, prophetic lineage, because from the father's side, from Imam Hassan, and from his mother's side also, his mother was a descendant of Imam Hussein. So he descended from both Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein. A great honor indeed for Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. Born in 470 AH, and then in 488 AH, after the Hijra, 488 AH, he migrated from Gilan to Baghdad. Baghdad was the seat of power of the Khilafah, the leadership of the Muslim Ummah. Yes, the Muslim Ummah. And so it was also the center of all the levers of power and influence in society. The center of political power, because the Khalifa was there. Economic power, Baghdad was the main seat for the Muslim Ummah. Educational influence, the main universities were there, madrasas, institutions of learning, all of it centered and focused in Baghdad, the capital of Iraq. So then it was the capital of the Ummah. And so he and his family migrated from Gilan to Baghdad. And at the same time of him coming to Baghdad, another great scholar of Islam was leaving Baghdad on his spiritual journey, Imam al-Ghazali, Imam Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, radiallahu anhu, the Hujjatul Islam, the proof of Islam, one of the greatest scholars of our Ummah. And he had established himself in Baghdad, became the greatest scholar there, head of the Nizamiya institution, which was the most prestigious institution of learning at that time in Baghdad. But after accomplishing all of this, at a relatively young age, he decided to leave all of that, leave all the comforts and the all the beautiful things of the dunya, because of his position, he could get whatever he wanted, left all of that to go on his spiritual journey. And after this spiritual journey, he became even greater, because that knowledge, that intellectual knowledge, was now nourished with spiritual grounding. And so he went on this journey. One of the wisdoms of Imam Ibn Atta'ila al-Sakandari, he says that if something or someone is not buried properly, is not immersed properly, if a seedling is not buried properly or planted properly, it will not grow forth or sprout forth beautiful fruits. It'll be crooked. And similarly, in our lives, if we don't bury ourselves in the art of obscurity, as the Imam mentioned, then you wouldn't be able to flourish beautifully. And so that burying in the art of obscurity, what it means really is that you go through the spiritual training.
if people don't go through that spiritual training, then they are deprived of the benefits of that spiritual training, and their lives are not the same as someone who's gone through that training. And so this is why it's important to have someone to help you on this path, such as a sheikh of spirituality, to guide you along the way, to hold you by your hands and take you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's interesting that as Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani is coming into Baghdad, then Imam Al-Ghazali is leaving for his spiritual journey. And later on, Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani would embark on this spiritual journey as well. In Baghdad now, he focused much on seeking knowledge of Islam. He devoted himself all his time and resources to seeking knowledge of Islam. And he became the student of some of the greatest teachers in Baghdad at that time, including Al-Imam Abu al-Wafa ibn Aqil, radiyallahu anhu, Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Hassan al-Baqilani, radiyallahu anhu, and Imam Abu Zakariya al-Tabrizi, radiyallahu anhu. These are some of the great teachers that he studied with and gained much knowledge with them. And he became, soon after spending some time with his teachers, he surpassed the knowledge of his teachers also. He was such a great student. And through the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him, he achieved amazing things in this phase of his life, pursuing knowledge of Islam. And so it's important that we understand the journey of Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. And I'm saying that we learn the lessons from his life so we can follow in his footsteps, follow this example. And one of the great things we should all do is to devote some time to seeking knowledge of Islam or religion. If you don't do that, then you are depriving yourself of a great benefit, the benefit of knowledge of deen. Because if you have knowledge of deen, in the hadith of the Prophet, he mentioned that this is the inheritance of the prophets. That if you want to gain something from the inheritance of the Prophet Muhammad, it is knowledge of deen, that we learn more and more with Islam. So you may not have the time to devote yourself totally to seek knowledge of deen, because depending on your stage in life, you have other things to do, and not everyone is required to devote all their time full time to seeking knowledge of deen. But a portion of your time that you can give for the deen, for Islam, the different projects we've launched before that you are doing, put some time to that so you can gain from it. And so it is, as you try to spend some time studying your religion, you gain more and you can do more. So Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, radiyallahu anhu, he did all he had to do to seek knowledge of Islam in Baghdad, reached the pinnacle. And then he turned to tasawwuf, to Islamic spirituality, this amazing science of one of the Islamic sciences of Islam, or knowledge, branch of knowledge of Islam, tasawwuf. That is an integral part of Islam. And the evidence, the dalil for this is the famous hadith of Angel Gabriel, hadith of Jibreel alayhi salam, where he talk about Iman, Islam, Iman, and Ihsan. And Ihsan now is
identifies this special science of Islam, ilm al-tasawwuf or ilm al-ihsan, ilm al-tazkiyah, which aims at purifying the individual, purifying your heart, purifying your soul, giving you that spiritual purification, tasawwuf. And tasawwuf beautifies every other aspect of your Islam. Every act of goodness that you do is beautified if it is based on tasawwuf, Islamic spirituality. Your prayer becomes better, becomes superior, more blessed if it's based on this purification, that you devote yourself totally and fully to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your fasting, everything, all your ibadah, all your good deeds, your entire life is decorated and beautified if it is based on this beautiful Islamic science of tasawwuf, purification of the self, purification of the nafs, purification of the heart, and so on. So Sayyidi Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani, after he had completed his journey of knowledge, then turned to tasawwuf, and he was guided firstly by Shaykh Abul Khair Hamad ibn Muslim al-Dabbas. And Imam al-Sha'rani says that this Shaykh Abul Khair Hamad ibn Muslim al-Dabbas, most of the students in Baghdad were his students. He was a great Shaykh of tasawwuf to train people on the spiritual path. And then after that, he went to his main Shaykh now. He joined the company of Qadi Abu Sa'id al-Makrami. His name was Mubarak ibn Ali ibn Hussein. And he was a great, accomplished, effective Sheikh of tasawwuf. And so Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani attached himself to him. And it is from him, Qadi Abu Sa'id al-Makrami, that he completed his training in tasawwuf. And Qadi Abu Sa'id gave him ijaza to initiate others in the Sufi tariqah. And so as he became a Sheikh of tasawwuf, and he started accepting disciples, and he founded the Qadiri tariqah or spiritual path, Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. So he accomplished all of that. And then now he started to teach others. He attached himself to the seminary or the madrasa of his teacher and sheikh, Qadi Abu Sa'id al-Makrami. He adopted that place as his madrasa, as his school, his place of teaching. And he would have frequent lectures and sermons there. And the attendance grew and became so large that they had to keep expanding this building, his seminary or madrasa, to hold the people that would come. And more people coming as his fame became more and more well known, became very famous and very popular. The people were attracted to him. He had something to teach people, to tell them about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the Prophet, to bring him closer to Allah, closer to the Prophet, to grant them real knowledge, true knowledge. And it would appear, some of the scholars mention, that if all of Baghdad would assemble for his congregations, for his sessions, Sheikh Muwaffaq ad-Din ibn Qudama, author of Al-Mughni. Al-Mughni is one of the famous fiqh references for the Hanbali madhab. He said, Imam ibn Qudama, that he had not seen a man
more respected and revered for his piety and religious learning than Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. So this great scholar in his own right, Sheikh Muwafiq ad-Din ibn Qudama, he's known popularly as Ibn Qudama, the author of Mughni, that great book on Hanbali Madhab, the fiqh of the Hanbali Madhab. He made this statement about Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. Even the king of the time, the Khalifa, his chief, his ministers, the ministers of the government, remember the seat of power, political power, was in Baghdad. They would attend the gatherings of Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. Scholars, jurists, students sat down together to listen to Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. It is reported that in a typical lecture that he would have, there would be as many as 400 ink pots, containers of ink, which were brought in to take down notes of his sermons. So popular it was. In those days, they would be writing with the felt pen, a wooden felt pen. They would insert it into the ink pot, and they would be writing. So the note takers would be doing that. And say for a typical lecture, 400 ink pot or containers of ink would be brought in for the recording of the lecture. There were so many people there in the lectures of Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. Remember how the sacrifices he went through to seek knowledge of Islam. And now he was, the fruits were bearing from the efforts. The tree was planted, it became firm, and it grew in a beautiful way, and it was bearing beautiful fruits to benefit all of humanity. The knowledge of Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, radiyallahu anhu. Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani was known to be a modest, humble, unpretentious person. He would often leave to take care, leave his work that he was doing, teaching classes and so on, to take care of the needs of a child, a destitute person, a slave girl, someone who is in need, take care of the needs of people. He was known for that. Someone came to him with a need, he would try to arrange to take care of the need of that person, either doing it himself or assigning his students to do so. And there's a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ in which he says, "Man nafasa an mu'minin kurbatan min kurbid dunya, nafasa Allahu anhu kurbatan min kurbil akhirah." Or kama qala alayhi salatu wasalam, if you take care of the needs of someone, a believer, in this dunya, man nafasa an mu'minin, you take care of the needs of a believer in this dunya, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of your need on the Day of Judgment. And that's the day when we are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And no one can take care of our need except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so this is something that we should always strive to do. Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani was like this. He would never evade the company of the poor. He would wash their clothes, perform similar personal services for them, or arrange for his students to do that. And he would always be honoring them and treating these poor people, underprivileged or less privileged people in need. He would treat them in a special way. Treat them in a special way. Make them feel special. Put a smile on their face in that way. And among the deeds that's loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to put a smile on the face of a person, like make someone happy. Min ahabbi a'mali ila Allah ta'ala. Among
the good deeds that's loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of his contemporaries said that he spent time in the company of Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, and he said he had not seen a man more polite, large-hearted, and charitable than Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani. But despite his fame, his popularity, his high status in society, he respected his elders, met the youngsters, young people with a good grace, always gave salams first, hailed the poor with courtesy and deference. He would be like this, treating people well in a special way. Another contemporary of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, Hafiz Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Yusuf al-Barzali, reports. He said about him, his prayers were readily answered. People noticed this about Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, that he would make dua for them, his prayers are answered. And so people would come to him often requesting him to make dua for them. And we make dua for them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his dua is usually answered. He had that special closeness of relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that his dua is answered. So this person, Hafiz Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Yusuf al-Barzali, reports, his prayers, his dua were readily answered. He was extremely tender-hearted. He would burst into tears. He would cry if anything sorrowful or touching was mentioned to him. Tender-hearted. He had a tender heart. You know, not a harsh, hard heart. Tender, soft heart. That he hears something sad, it would bring tears to his eyes. He is concerned for the Muslim ummah. Muslims are suffering, it would bring tears to his eyes. That is what he was. Hafiz Abu Abdullah continued, very often he was to be found immersed in meditation, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He spent his time, whatever extra time he had, free time, engaged in remembrance and dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was soft-hearted, courteous, cheerful, generous, and compassionate. And he was the offspring of a noble family. This is known. It was known then that who his ancestors were. Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein. So he came from that noble progeny, noble family. And in addition to that, he was known for his profound piety and true knowledge. This is what Hafiz Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Yusuf al-Barzali mentioned. Another contemporary of Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani, Sheikh Muhyiddin Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Hamid al-Baghdadi, a jurist, a scholar, faqih of that time, he says, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani was always disposed to avoid things unseemly. He only sought after the desirable and befitting things. In other words, the refineness of his character, how he was. He would become angry if divine commandments were neglected. People were not following the right way. They were doing wrong things. They were committing wrong things. That would make him displeased. But he would never seek revenge for himself, only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He never sent back a beggar without giving him something. If he had nothing to give, he would part with clothes he had, give them something, or point them out, direct them to where they can get something from one of his associates, one of his students. He was always like this, Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, radiyallahu anhu. He had many great titles, and inshallah in a future lecture, we'll talk more about that, the titles of this great Sheikh. He had beautiful gems of wisdom that he shared with the Ummah that we can continue to benefit from, inshallah. And so this amazing personality, Sayyidi Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani, radiyallahu anhu, we honor him, remember him, learn important lessons from his life, and strive to follow in his footsteps. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring us close to him in this dunya and in the akhirah. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله
نور ولا يا حي نور لك الرأي حي
نور ولا يا حي نور لك الرأي حي سارے عالم میں كيسا نور چايا ہے الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله جب تلك یہ چار تارے
السلام عليك يا رب
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا
واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم. يا أكرم
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
قطب النقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى
الروح له أدنى ثمن قطب اللقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن قد دل على المولى وسما في الفضل إلى أعلى كنن قد دل على المولى وسما في الفضل إلى أعلى كنن ودا في هذا العلم بما قد زاد على أبهى فنن قد كل قطى بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن معرفة المولى غايته فاتبعه على هذا السنن معرفة المولى غايته فاتبعه على هذا السنن ورسول الله وسيلته فاغرف من هاتيك السنن قطب اللقطى بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن وأساس بناء طريقته تطهير القلب من الدرن وأساس بناء طريقته تطهير القلب من الدرن فاسلك بالاسم المفرد يا صوفي وبالحق استعن قطب اللقطى بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن حب وفن عن الأكوان فما يبقى إلا من فيه فني حب وفن عن الأكوان فما يبقى إلا من فيه فني وادخل أبواب الغيب وسل ما شئت وللأسرار سوي قطب اللقطى بمدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن واشرب كأس العرفان وذق سر التوحيد ولا تكن واشرب كأس العرفان وذق سر التوحيد ولا تكن وبحب
البشاري وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى أروح له أدنى ثمن واشكر لله وصل على طه في السر وفي العلن واشكر لله وصل على طه في السر وفي العلن وعلى آل البيت جميعا يا حل وسلم واستقني قطب الأقطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى أروه له أدنى ثمن قطب الأقطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى أروه له أدنى ثمن وابذل يعقوب جاهلا دعوى في أثواب الكفن وابذل يعقوب جاهلا دعوى في أثواب الكفن فاتف يا مولاي عليه وعلينا جمعا بالمنن وابذل الأقطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى أروه له أدنى ثمن قطب الأقطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى أروه له أدنى ثمن أروه له أدنى ثمن أروه له
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين
لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا إن في الجنة نهرا من لبن إن في الجنة نهرا من لبن لعلي وحسين وحسن لعلي وحسين وحسن لا إله إلا الله 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 محمد رسول الله يا مولانا كل من كان محبا لهم كل من كان محبا لهم يدخل الجنة من غير هزان، يدخل الجنة من غير هزان. لا إله إلا الله، الله الله، محمد رسول الله يا مولانا. كل من سار على دربهم، كل من سار على دربهم، يدخل الجنة من غير حزن، يدخل الجنة من غير حزن. لا إله إلا الله، الله الله، محمد رسول الله يا مولانا. حب أهل البيت فرض عندنا، حب أهل البيت فرض عندنا، وبهذا الحب لا نخشى المهان، وبهذا الحب لا نخشى المهان. لا إله إلا الله، الله الله، محمد رسول الله يا مولانا. لا إله إلا الله، الله الله، محمد رسول الله يا مولانا.
لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها.
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها.
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها.
صلى
خير الخلق وأحلاها.
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بيبي آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بيبي آمنا کے پول
الله الله جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے پور و غلما بھی خوشیاں سرکار تشریف لانے لگے پور و غلما بھی خوشیاں منانے لگے ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی مل گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی
رسول
محمد رسول الله الله بيبي آمنا كيقول الله الله
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين.
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله
صلوا على رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد أشرف العرب والعجم محمد خير من يمشي على قدمي محمد بسيط المعروف جامعه محمد صاحب الإحسان والكرم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد تاج رسل الله قاطبة محمد صادق الأقوال والكلم محمد ثابت الميثاق حافظه محمد طيب الأخلاق والشيم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد جبلت بالنور تينته محمد لم يزل نورا من القدم محمد حكيم بالعدل ذو شرف محمد مدين الإنعام والحكم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد خير خلق الله من مضر محمد خير رسل الله كلهم محمد دينه حق ندين به محمد مشرك حقا على عالم
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد ذكره روح لأنفسنا محمد شكره فرض على الأمم محمد رحيم الله العباد به محمد سبب الإنشاء من عدم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله.
لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله.
الله والله 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 الله والله لا إله إلا الله
الله
وعلينا تعدف يا أملي
صحب الغر ما أبدى الطائر تغريدا. الله 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 لا إله إلا الله. May He Almighty send on you countless prayers to elevate you and all your companions and offspring, as long as a bird reminds of you. Allahu, 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 Allah, Allahu, Allah, la ilaha illallah. Ma madda li khayril khalqi yada ahadun illa wa bihi sa'ida.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. وبعد، my dear respected beloved brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. May the peace and blessings of Almighty Allah be with each and every one of you. And thanks for joining us today for our daily live stream broadcast. This program it starts coming to you from your Zawiya here at Islamic Forum, and it starts at 7 p.m. Toronto time. We thank you for joining us today. We hope you can be with us every day, inshallah, 7 p.m. Toronto time. Do remember to reach out to your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know. Tell them about the program. Encourage them to watch the program. Remind them to watch the program. Sign into the chat. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program. You'll receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want to remind you of the special Remembrance Day Mawlid that we are having on during the Remembrance Day weekend. It would be on Sunday, November the 13th, starting at 12 noon here at the Islamic Forum. So registration is required. Do remember to register if you haven't already done so. And to register, you can sign into the chat and let us know that you're attending the program and how many members of your family are coming and their names, inshallah. You put that in the chat so we can register you for the program. Then also the Surat al-Ikhlas Khatam that we're doing now. The special Khatam, and kindly update us in the chat about your progress for the Khatam of Surat al-Ikhlas, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for doing so. We want to thank all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them and enrich them many more times for their donation to the Islamic Forum. At the top of the chat, there are special messages from the admin staff. We want to remind you of the book that we're featuring in the season of Rabia. Season of Rabia, including Rabi al-Awwal, Rabi al-Thani. We are now in the second half of the season of Rabia. And so the book that we're featuring in this season is Blessings of Salawat. You can get your copies of the book, but the link is in the chat. In the top of among those messages at the top of the chat, there's a link for the book. You can click on the link to get your book, inshallah, for yourself and for your loved ones, family members, relatives, and friends. So you can give them as a gift, inshallah. It's a wonderful way for you to increase your blessings and ongoing blessings, inshallah. At the top of the chat today, we welcome Sidi Sharif al-Faisal and family from Scarborough. So the greetings should be two greetings, inshallah, Rabi Athani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings. Siti Maryam McGee, Siti Bilal, Siti Elijah from Richmond, Virginia, United States, welcome. Wishing Rabi Athani Mubarak greetings, Maulid Mubarak greetings to our beloved Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, your beloved Nool parents and family, the Murids, admin staff, and the IFC family. Shukran, Siti Maryam, for remembering everyone, and especially mention my parents and family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, bless your family, inshallah. And once again, for everyone, just be mindful of how Siti Maryam, CDMR are doing their greetings, so you can follow that pattern, inshallah. CDMR Al-Faisal and family from London, welcome. Wishing Rabi Athani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings to our beloved Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, your beloved Nood parents and family, the Murids, admin staff, and the IFC family. Shukran CDMR. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, bless your family. Thanks for remembering everyone, and especially for mentioning my parents and family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, make dua for you, inshallah. And we hope you are successful in your exams and assignments you have now for university. We also receive a message from Sidi Ansar Afridi in Karachi, Pakistan. He did his exams recently, and alhamdulillah, he came first in his class. He was a top student for his class for the recent exams. We want to congratulate Sidi Ansar Afridi from Karachi, Pakistan. Sidi Hasib, Sidi Asia, Sidi Asil, Sidi Nusheen, Sidi Aram, Sidi Akif, welcome to all of you. Wishing Rabi al-Awwal Mubarak and Maulid Mubarak greetings to IFC family. Shukran, alhamdulillah. Sis Nafisa Nabi and family from Princess Tongue in Trinidad in the West Indies, welcome. Thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. Sister Bibi Ibrahim, Brother Muhammad Ibrahim and family from Pembroke Pines in Florida in the United States, welcome to all of you. Thanks for joining us. Sidi Ashab Bakas, Sidi Sherry Bakas, Sidi Rajab from Brothers Village, East Bank, Barbies in Guyana, South America. Welcome, alhamdulillah. Wishing Rabi Athani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings to beloved Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, the beloved Nool parents and family, the Marie's admin staff, and the IFC family. We recited Weird Alarm after Fajr, after Maghrib today, and one page of Quran up to tab 7. Very nice, alhamdulillah. Shukran, Sidi Shah. Thanks for remembering everyone. Mention my parents and family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, bless your entire family. Give my salams to all the Murids there, inshallah. And contact them tonight, tomorrow. Remind them to join your halakha, inshallah, for dhikr. Siti Wahid Shah, Lachman and family from Avocat Jamaat in Trinidad and West Indies, welcome. Thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. Siti Halima Khan and family from Markham, welcome. Sister Bibi Farida, Babs and Omar from Pembroke Pines in Florida in the United States, welcome, alhamdulillah. So do remember both greetings, Rabi Athani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings. And we want to thank you for your donation to Islam Forum, alhamdulillah. Sister Bibi Zaminu Razak and family from Cotton Tree Village, West Coast Barbados in Guyana, South America, welcome. Sidi Ansar Afridi from Karachi, Pakistan, welcome. And once again, congratulations on coming first in your class in the recent exams, alhamdulillah. Brother Keith MacDonald, Sister Brother Juan from Toronto, welcome, alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us. Siti Razia Khan, Siti Tariq from Scarborough, Sis Yasmin from Bowmanville. Welcome, wishing Rabi Athani Mubarak greetings, Maulid Mubarak greetings, the Sayyidina Sheikh family, the Murid's IFC family. Shukran, Siti Razia, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Sister Shireen Jabbar and family from Scarborough, welcome. Brother Mustafa Bashiruddin, Sister Zareen Bashiruddin from Markham, welcome. Migda for you as requested, inshallah. Thanks for joining us. Sidi Jesse Moroni from Los Angeles in the United States, welcome. Thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. This is Rabi Athani Mubarak and Maulid Mubarak greetings. to IFC family. May Allah SWT elevate our beloved Sheikh Faisal. Shukran Sidi Jasmuri, thanks for joining us. May Allah SWT bless you. Sidi Nadeem Malik from Birmingham, United Kingdom. Welcome, Sidi Nadeem. Thanks for joining us. May Allah SWT bless you. We hope you can join us often, inshallah. Give my salams to the brothers and sisters here in Birmingham. Sister Shakila Majid and family from Florida, United States, welcome. Sister Roxanne Begum and family from Brampton, welcome. Today recited up Surat An-Nisa for the IFC Quran Project and 3,000 salawat for 920,000 salawat for the IFC Salawat Project. Siti Halim Khan says, Maulid Mubarak, Rabia Thani Mubarak, and Maulid Mubarak greetings to Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal. Our pious in the Sheikh for his parents and family, Phil Maurice, Admin Staff, IFC family. Shukran, Siti Halim Khan. Siti Shamir, Siti Samir, Siti Amir, Siti Shabir, Siti Shafir, Siti Shazi, Siti Sadiq, Siti Alim, Siti Medina from Queens, New York, in the United States. Welcome. Sister Mariska Jenny, Brother Muhammad Ma'azam from Mississauga. Welcome. And we make dua for you, inshallah, that you get good news from the doctor, inshallah. And you can kindly ask Brother Mazam to call us after the call CD, after the live stream broadcast tonight, inshallah. We sent him a message, WhatsApp message, so you can check that. Siti Halim Khan says the Surat Al-Ikhlas Khatam today 300 for a total of 1500 out of the 2000 pledge. So Alhamdulillah, Siti Halima reciting another 300 Surat Al-Ikhlas today. So she's reached 1500 so far out of the total pledge of 2000. Very nice. So once again for all of you, please try to participate in the Surat Al-Ikhlas Khatam and update us in the chat, inshallah. And Sid Helm says, Salawat Project 4,000 today for 290,000. Quran Project, Abisut Ali Imran, and recite Weird Alarm 3 times today. Siti Anisa Khan and family from Ottawa, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. Wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings to the IFC family. Shukran. Siti Sabiha Qadir, Siti Kamran, Sarah, and Nigat from Chicago, Illinois, United States, welcome. Wishing Rabi Thani Mubarak greetings. And do remember the Maulid Mubarak greetings to our dear Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, his noble parents and family, Admin Staff, El Muriz, IFC family. Shukran Siti Sabiha. May Allah bless you, make dua for you and your entire family. Brother Asan Shabir and family from Italy, welcome all the way from Italy. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. She tell you make dua for you as requested, inshallah. Sister Baitu Zahara, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. And do remember to put your city, country you're from. Thanks for joining us. We hope you can join us every day, 7 p.m. Toronto time, inshallah. Siti Rahim, Siti Riyan, Siti Bibi and family from Prisal, Halak and Trinidad in West Indies, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. And Sister Baidu Zahra, we make dua for Atiya Fatima. Inshallah. Sister Shireen Shah from Brampton, welcome. Wishing Rabia Thani Mubarak and Maulid Mubarak greetings to Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, the admin staff, and their family. And Surat Al-Ikhlas Khatam, 100 today for 800 so far out of the 1,000 pledge. Very nice. You're getting close to finishing 100, year 1,000, your first share. They can take a second share, inshallah. IFC Quran Project up to chapter 2. Very nice. Alhamdulillah. Sister Shireen from Brampton. Siti Lazima Kharmular from Pinal, Halak and Trinidad in West Indies, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah. This is Baitu Zahra from Brampton. Shukran, thanks for letting us know. I'm hoping you join us regularly, inshallah. Sidi Mark Jarrett from St. Joseph in Michigan, welcome. Wishing Rabbi Al-Awwal Mubarak and Maulid Mubarak greetings to Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, admin staff, Marie's IFC family. Weirdalam, one time today, Quran project up to page 7 of the Quran. So if you can put the surah number and the verse number. So here it will be Surah Al-Baqarah, and put it the ayah number, the verse number where you stopped, inshallah. Siti Hawa Vivian, Siti Uzair from Los Angeles, United States, welcome. Wishing Rabbi Al Mubarak and Maulid Mubarak greetings to Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, Maurice IFC family. Shukran, Siti Hawa and Siti Uzair. May Allah SWT bless both of you. Alhamdulillah. Siti Zahir Ihsan from San Diego, United States, welcome. Alhamdulillah. Do remember the Maulid greetings. So you say Rabbi Athani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings. Sister Bibi Rasool and family from Etobicoke, welcome. Alhamdulillah, wishing Rabbi Athani Mubarak greetings and Maulid Mubarak greetings to IFC family. We make dua for you as requested, inshallah. Adibeti Amin and Dean from Toronto, welcome. Wishing Rabbi Athani Mubarak and Maulid Mubarak greetings to Zaini Sheikh Faisal's family, IFC family. Shukran. And Sidi Mark Jarrett asks a question. Sheikh, is it okay to recite the Weird Alarm on my commute to work? Jazak, my friend, thanks for all that you do. Oh, yeah, this is okay. The Weird Alarm, you can recite on your way to work. Because sometimes you're busy in the morning, so after Fajr, and you don't get to do it, so you have to do it every day. So on your way to work, you can be reciting it. This is why we recommend that you memorize the Weird Alarm, so wherever you are, you can be reciting it. Now, you should also be mindful, especially in North America, with the time for Fajr, that it's getting later now as we enter the winter month. So rather than doing after Fajr, you can also do it before Fajr. You know, you can get a bit earlier and do your Weird Alarm before Fajr, so you get to do it every day. Nevertheless, if you're not, any day you're not able to do it at that time, you do it as soon as possible thereafter. So it's good to do it on your commute to work because you're doing dhikr. It's a great source of blessings. And you should do it every day, inshallah. Because you want to do it twice a day, but if you can do it more, you do it more. So when you're commuting to work and you returning home from work in the evening, you can be doing your dhikr, inshallah. And you can resend me the message on WhatsApp. Because sometimes I'm busy, I don't get to respond to messages. And then also, for Maurice, the messages, I may not respond directly, but I'll respond on the program during the night. Like in this session, the interactive session at the end of the program, I would respond to your messages or questions if you send on WhatsApp or email me or so like that. Because during the day, I may be busy and I don't get to respond to all the messages. So this is why it's important that you all try to be with us every night for the program. Especially if you ask a question, you expect an answer, this is the time that I'll respond to you, inshallah. Nevertheless, Sidi Mark, send me that message again. Sidi Faisal Tahir from Vancouver. Welcome, Sidi Faisal. Thanks for joining us. Alhamdulillah, make the few requested, inshallah. This is Zairul. Auntie Betty's Salawat update 1,000 today, and Surah Al-Ikhlas 1,000 for a total of 7,000 out of the 10,000 that was pledged. So Aunty Betty pledged 10,000 and she finished 7,000 so far. Very nice, alhamdulillah. Sister Mariska Jenny, requesting dua for in-laws, husband, herself. Make dua for all of you, inshallah. Alhamdulillah. And Sidi Faisal says, completed the Khatm of the Quran. Alhamdulillah, very nice. Another Khatm of the Quran, very good. Sister Abidan says, Shamaila and family from Manchester, United Kingdom, welcome. Recite 4 verses of the Quran today and 25,000 salawat. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. And Cesare Migdo as requested, inshallah. And Siti Halim Khan says, congratulations, Siti Ansar, on your exam results. Alhamdulillah, he's doing very well. May Allah bless him with more success. Siti Maramagi says, mashallah, Siti Ansar, proud of you. Alhamdulillah, Siti Ansar did very well. Sidi Mariam says, Sayyidina Sheikh, is the Quran recited at the Masjid in Mecca and Medina all day? Where's hard allowed? It sounds beautiful. No, it's not recited all day. Because people are, it's busy, the Masjid, all day, people are praying and so on. So they don't have that recitation. They have their broadcast channel. And on the channel now, they have recitations much of the day because they have other programs they do as well, inshallah. So it's not recited in the masjid all day allowed. Sister Bibi Rasool says, completed 800 surah class out of a total of 1,000 pledge. Very nice. Inshallah, you finish off your first year soon and you can take another share, another 1,000 for the surah class project. I want all of you to participate in this Ikhlas project because then you get a blessing for it first and foremost, but then you get in the habit of doing this great spiritual deed of Surah Al-Ikhlas Khatam. It has great blessings, inshallah. So it's good to do it now because we do different Khatams at different times. Like remember last month we did the Fatiha Khatam. Now we're doing the Surah Al-Ikhlas Khatam. But we wouldn't do it all the time. Once Rabi Athani finish, then it finishes, this Khatm of Surah Al-Ikhlas. So it's good if you can do it and try to push yourself to do as much as you can. And it's very easy. Everyone knows Surah Al-Ikhlas. You know, throughout the day, you can be reciting it and have your counter, you count it like this, inshallah. Once again, I want to encourage you, all of you, to do the Surah Al-Ikhlas Khatm. So this is Bibi Rasool completed 800 out of the 1,000 that she pledged. Siti Shaz Fakhatri and family from Orange County in United States, welcome. So there should be two greetings, Rabi Athani and also Maulid Mubarak greetings. Quran Project, Surah Zumar, very good. We miss you for a few days, Siti Shaz Fakhatri. I hope you're well, inshallah. So those are the brothers and sisters in the chat. We'll make dua now for everyone in the chat, special dua for them because they took the time, extra effort to sign into the chat and give us the update on the different projects and so on. This is very important to interact with the program. So special dua for everyone in the chat. Everyone watching the program, special dua for you. And our entire IFC family, we make dua for them. Then all our donors, we make special dua for all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday and before. For all those who register for the special program, the Remembrance Day Maulid, on November the 13th, Sunday, 12 noon, here at Islamic Forum. Make special of all of you, and I want to encourage everyone to register for the program as soon as possible. May Allah bless you for doing so. And all those who participating in the Surah Al-Ikhlas Khatam, We want to make special dua for them. Whatever dua you like to make, put that knee in your heart, and we make that dua on your behalf. So kindly raise your hands and join me in dua. اللهم آمين أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ودخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله اللهم آمين 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 Do remember to type Ameen in the chat so you can get more blessings, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase in tawfiq and kubul and ziyadah. We thank you for watching the program tonight. We hope you can join us every night, inshallah, 7 p.m. Toronto time. The program starts at 7 p.m. Toronto time, and we have a fixed format for the program. From 7 p.m. to 8 p.m., we do our Quran recitation, our dhikr, and then dua. From 8 to 9, we do the lectures. The first lecture, short one, for the different projects. Then the main lecture of the night. Then from 9 to 9:30 thereabouts, we do the Qasida training, and then we do the interactive session, which this session now, inshallah. So we hope you can join us every night, 7 p.m. Toronto time. Do remember to tell your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know, tell them about the program. Encourage them to watch your program and sign into the chat. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program, and you will receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you always in the shade of His special mercies. Until we meet again, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.